everybody.
Hi.
Well, we're Facebook Live. We've been in suspended animation all day here, and now we're just...
Now we're live.
Coming alive to sing some chants here.
I wanted to take an opportunity before we start to sing to mention that we are offering a nightly series called Deep, Daily Deep Peace. And in these one-hour sessions each night from 7 to 8 Pacific time, we're offering some sort of simple but time-tested tools through the yoga lineage that we've been studying. And maybe you can tell us a little bit about what those things are.
Yeah, well, the main focus of it is breath training, using a breath pillow and really strengthening your diaphragm, which helps activate your parasympathetic nervous system, which keeps you calm, keeps you relaxed, keeps you breathing deep and free and easy when things are a little haywire. So
on the outside.
And then the other part of it is a systematic relaxation and also a little bit of guided meditation. That's sort of part of the lineage that Kristin and I are a part of, and we're pretty blessed to have this knowledge and to be able to share it with people. It seems pretty important right now, particularly.
Super important. It's always important, but it's even more important now. And we just completed the first 10-day session this morning. So tonight at 7 p.m. Pacific, you can find the links on our High on Love Facebook page. There are events posted there with Eventbrite ticket links. It's all sliding scale, so you can choose your own price. And we're also carrying on with a morning session that just starts tomorrow, but you can join in any day. And it's at 9 o'clock Pacific time.
In the morning and 7 in the evening.
Pacific time.
Well,
because we know there are people everywhere watching.
I just wanted to take a moment to say thank you to our dear friend David Botten. We love you dearly. Thank you for letting us borrow this beautiful cajon drum. We are grateful to have a lot of beautiful people here on Gabriola that we sing with and share music together with. And they've been incredibly generous and kind with their time and musical instruments and willingness to share their inspiration with us. So thank you. We love you, all of you.
Okay. So we've chosen from our long list of Kirtan songs, and we'll share a few with you this evening. Feel free to sing along or dance along. A few people said they were dancing to the last songs we shared, so that's fun. And
maybe we can just start with three ohms.
That's a great idea. Where'd this little guy go? How about this? Feel free to close your eyes. And just relax with us for a few minutes.
Taking a nice deep breath in. Ah, and sighing. And then a nice deep breath in again. And sigh one more time. We made it. And inhale to Om three times.
First chant we've selected for this evening is Govinda Jaya Jaya. you want to tell us what the words are?
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopala Jaya Jaya. And that repeats, so this chant will sing call and response. And the second line is Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya. But we'll sing all the lines together, but we'll sing through each one twice so you can join along and sing the second line as the response.
Are we doing a call and response? Or are we singing together?
Yeah, we'll sing together.
Okay.
Jaya, Jaya.
Anandamayi Ma?
Sure. I didn't really practice the chords for this. I think you better just play it on guitar.
Yeah.
I'll sing with you then.
Okay. Anandamayi Ma is the name of this chant. Pardon me. That last chant was a Jaya, Uttal chant. I'm not sure who sings this one, but it's a really beautiful chant.
I feel like Daniel Tucker said he made this one up.
Yeah, maybe. That sounds right.
We'll go with that.
So the words are Bhaja Mana Ma 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 Ma. Bhaja Mana Ma 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 Ma. And that those two lines together actually repeat. So we'll sing through that twice. And then the second sort of verse is Ananda Mayi Ma Ma Ananda Rupa Ma Ma, and then that will repeat. So
this chant is really a honoring of the great mother and the goddess archetype,
and part of it is also singing to our mind these names, the rupa repetition of these names brings our mind into a focused one-pointedness that is desirable most every time we do this bhakti practice.
Anandamayi Ma Ma almost ran out of breath there.
One takes a little huffing and puffing sometimes.
Not a lot of space to take breaths there.
I'd also like to take a minute to say thank you to our dear friend Ode Howard. I highly doubt that he's watching right now because it's probably in the middle of the night where he is in India, but I've been learning to play guitar the last 3 months. He was kind enough to lend me his guitar and really got me inspired to learn and to sing. So now I have bought myself this guitar and I've really been enjoying playing it, and I'm grateful to Ode for being willing to lend me his so that I could really dive into learning playing guitar, and yeah, I've just really been enjoying it. So
you're a fast learner.
Yeah. Well, you want to do Jaya Ganesha Deva or Jaya Ganesha Deva?
Sure.
Yeah.
Probably Jaya Ganesha Deva. So there are a lot of words to this song. And it goes, Jai Ganesha Deva, Jai Durga Ma, Uma Parvati Anandama, Hari Om Nama Shivaya, Om Nama Shivaya, Maha Deva Shambho. And
it's not call and response. I mean, it can be call and response.
If you want to make it call and response,
it's
you
the
can.
Whole thing. So.
It's a lot of words. A lot of words to respond to. So it's a good one. We heard this in Guatemala, and some of our other friends here on Gabriola played it and reminded us how much we really love it.
And this is Mahashivatri, yeah? This week, I think it's 10 days.
No.
No?
No. That happened at the beginning of this month.
Oh, did it?
Yeah. Time. Yes. There's a bit of a time warp happening right now.
Yeah, it's a
for most of us.
Time release.
Anandamayi. there one you want to play on the harmonium?
I could sing Hey Ma Durga. I could sing Samadhi Sita Ram too.
Sure.
Why don't I play that one just for fun?
Sure.
You want to use this, or do you want to
slide over?
Yeah.
We have two more songs.
Well,
just getting situated here.
Wow. Krishna Das is definitely one of my biggest inspirations for all the songs that we sing and chant. And if you see me roaming around, there's a good chance that Krishna Das is playing on my phone, even when I'm at work. On these work sites, singing these mantras, and these guys are like, what the heck are you singing, man?
Actually, a few weeks, maybe a month ago now, on Spotify, I turned on Spotify and a thing popped up that said, you're in the top 1% of Krishna Das's fans worldwide. And I was like, yep, that's not surprising, right here.
So this is a chant that we had on our Spotify for a long time, and finally, I felt like, personally, I progressed enough musically on the harmonium to learn to play this chant, so pretty exciting kind of development when you sort of leap into another category of being able to learn new songs, more complicated songs and stuff. So I will sing this song. It's very repetitive and there's not many words. It's just Rama Rama Ram, Sita Rama Rama Ram. Hare Rama Rama Ram, Sita Rama Rama Ram. And then there's a second section that goes Ram Ram, Sita Ram, Ram Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Ram Ram, Sita Ram. But I'll play it all call and response, so you can sing that second line. I guess there's one other section. It's a lot of information.
Shri it's mostly the same words, though.
Shri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. It's not any complicated words, really, so. What is that one?
Yeah.
Change. Okay, we have one more for you, and
might be able to sit with your ear.
Sure, yeah. I feel inspired to share this one. It's one of the newer ones that I've been learning, and this morning a friend in the States changed her profile picture on Facebook to be the goddess Kali, who is kind of a scary lady. And she, if you don't know what she looks like, look her up. She is the goddess of sort of burning away bad karma, maybe.
Well, I think she's the goddess of death and transformation, which a lot of people have not a very good connotation or view of death. But the death of some things is transformation into another, and the rebirth into something new. And so this sort of thing is necessary and a very totally natural part of nature and natural things. So. Anyways.
Supernatural.
Supernatural, even.
So, Om Namo Kali. Kali Om Namo. I don't know who actually wrote this song, but we learned it from some friends here on Gabriola. Mala is a friend of ours here, and she plays it on her guitar in a really beautiful way. So I decided to learn it on harmonium. And actually, most of this song is in English, so you'll be able to understand pretty well if you speak English.
Then burn it all. serve us, then burn it all away. Burn it all away, Kali, burn it all away. If it doesn't serve us, then burn it all away. Oh,
thank God we're in solitude with each other, socially distancing ourselves and chanting our faces off while we're having our little time out from life. It's a beautiful thing if you make it into that, so find something fun and joyful to do with your time and let the time fly by.
Okay, well, 5:45 already. Thanks for joining us, or thanks for watching the replay, whichever. And we hope you enjoyed our sharing of our our newfound musical skills and our passion for bhakti, the practice of devotion, one of many ways to connect with the divine that's within all of us and everywhere else. Namaste.
Namaste.
Thank you.
We love you.
Stay tuned for when we're going to do this again. We're figuring it all out day by day. Okay, have a great evening.
Bye.